Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Jurassic Park Builder. We are, well, got quite a lot to show you today, actually. This isn't even the second day of recording. I've done a lot. Let's put it that way. So, let's start off with the evolutions, because there's three of them on the way. Look, these three beautiful things over there. I'm going to quickly show you guys over here as well. As you can see, I have started my collection of security officers, because 420 every hour. It started to happen fairly regularly that I'm away for an hour or so each time, and I come back and I've got like all of the money in the world. It's beautiful. Anyways, not important. What is important is I have figured out how to zoom in. I said this last video, and this time I've actually done it. Now the problem was I was holding control and scrolling my wheel. That doesn't work. You have to click, hold control, and zoom. Yes! See? And a social message. Wolfric, who farted? Have some help. There we go. So let's go do some evolutions, shall we? 1 second, make my way. I've zoomed in quite far, in case you can't tell. So I'm going to start on the bottom right. This should be the Brachiosaurus. Boop! And there we go. Even despite the fact that it's still a babby, you can see him quite clearly. You can see all the new markings. Definitely is an improvement on what he used to look like. I'm going to go ahead and save the grass for now. And in this corner, we have the Dilophosaurus. Boop! Still difficult to see. However, I am fairly loaded with meat. I was going to do that, but we're not going to. You'll see why in a minute. There he is, looking kind of beautiful. Nearly is. Well, that's his max evolution. Now that's what his final design looks like. And he's adorable, isn't he? It's so much better now that we can see this up close. There's our Triceratops, looking very cool. Very cool. And up here we have yet another evolution. It is Pachycephalosaurus. Hooray! Very cute as well. So Pachycephalosaurus, Dilophosaurus, and the Triceratops are all max level, I believe? Or do they have to evolve one more time each? You know what? I don't know. I don't care. Anyways, moving up, we can take a quick look at all our dinosaurs. Somebody pointed out that the Ceratosaurus has a really small paddock, and he does. I'm not really sure why it's so tiny, but it is. And then we've got a little baby Spinosaurus, and down here is our Baryonyx, looking very cool. Nope. Compsognathus. And Velociraptors, very nice. A Parasaurolophus. Can't even remember. Allosaurus, that's it, it's Al. There's Al and there's Albert. Gallimimus, nearly there. Camarasaurus, is that it? Nope. Coryphosaurus, and our new arrival, the Pterodactylus. Boop! The name Pterodactylus means wing finger. Oh, that's so tiny! Anyway, this is why I've been saving up a rather extreme amount of meat, as you can see. And this will actually complete a mission as well. Thank you, Mr. Can't actually remember your name. What's his name? Oh god! Malcolm! Ian Malcolm! Whew. There we go. Oh, let's have a quick little look. Collect 1,000 crops. Oh, I can do that, no problem. And nope. Expand the park. I've got an Acrocanthosaurus. Cool beans. Anyway, so let's get these guys up to level 5, shall we? Ready? Boop! There we go, Pterodactylus. They're kind of adorable. In a really creepy way. Anyways, now we've hit the point where I've got quite a lot of meat and quite a lot of plants left, so we may as well go spend them on something. So let's nip back down here. I want to focus on my low level ones first. So, 1,200 for them, or... No. Screw it! I got, like, 2 levels out of that. That was horrific. Oh, well. And let's go do the same with our Dilophosaurus. Might get to level 5? Yes, there we go. Much better. No, they cap at level 50, don't they? Yeah, they've both got an evolution to go. There you go. But you guys should be able to see the Dilophosaurus in a little bit more detail now. Quite an attractive little beast, isn't he? Yes, yes he is. We have to set that up because we're going to need some crops. Let's get that going. And we'll get that going as well. Now, that is it for the main Jurassic Park, but we have more to go yet, so let's head over to the aquatic park. Very exciting. I know. You guys have been great with helping out. You know, pretty much as soon as I get that first piece of DNA to activate the research, you guys are all over it. It's like, it takes about 20 seconds for me to max it out. It's great. Oh, I didn't realize I had this. Okay. Come on, let's hope for the best. No! Rubbish. No. Okay, and we're going to zoom in again because we want to get some detail on our aquatic creatures. Well, the dinosaurs are really, like, detailed and crisp and clean and everything else looks horrendous. So, yep, there we go. Boop. That's our Chronosaurus. Over here we have our, can't remember, Tylosaurus. I think that's everyone. Okay. First things first, we have an evolution with our Hammondite. Now, it's quite hard to tell what he's done. I think there's just some darker stripes in the shell, more than anything. If you remember, we've got a quest in here to have 2 stars on crustaceivores, so that's why we're working, that's why we've evolved the Ammonite, basically, and that's why we're going to evolve the Platycarpus as well. But this all pales in comparison to something else very exciting that's happening. It's yet another new creature. I'm very excited. Boop! Siphactinus. Now, as far as I can tell, this was a limited edition creature. It was out for a few days, and you had to be lucky enough to get the DNA sample in that time period. So I feel quite lucky. And there we go. Siphactinus. This is basically a huge piranha. And I've been saving up fish expressly for the purpose of trying to get it to level 5. I suspect we're going to fall a bit short. Yes, we are. Bugger. They're very hard to level up, the people in the aquatic, because I really don't want to spend the money to upgrade the thingamajiggy, what do you call it? The harbours down here. I don't know why, I'm just too lazy, I don't want to spend the cash, I want to spend it on other things like buying a bazillion security officers. Oh well. To the glacial park! Whew! I'm not sure I'm going to have anything to show you guys tomorrow, I've done everything in this bit of the video. Oh well. We do have yet another surprise. It's not really a surprise, you guys know what's coming. It's not even slightly a surprise. Oh! This could be a surprise, who knows? Is it gonna be a surprise? It's, oh, dino dolls. Ooh, nope. One day, guys, one day. Let's click that, click that. I started just putting money into these just over time, just kind of building up my stocks. I really should upgrade them, but maybe I will. Maybe I'll upgrade them. Anyways, let's zoom in. Boop, 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 boop. Zoom, come on, there we go. Let's get back over here, and are we ready for our final new creature, the third new creature for this video, as well as the 3 evolutions? Been a busy day, I tell you. In 3, 2, 1, boop! It's a Entelodon! Means perfect teeth. It kind of looks like a warthog type thing. Splendid! Oh god, go away, no. Right, what do you want, Malcolm? Place 2 info igloos. Now they're really expensive. feed Entelodon. I can do that! I've been saving up meat especially for this purpose. So many dino dollars! We are working on it. It's 490 for the T-Rex. This puts us at about... We're over a quarter of the way there now. Just about. Not much over a quarter, but we are over a quarter. This guy's really cheap to level up. Quite surprised. Right, one more, one more. Boop! There we go. There's our strange little warthog type fellow. Zoom out again so you can get a full view of him, but come on, come on, come on, zoom. Don't let me down now. Okay, I think zoom's gonna let me down now. Did I zoom out? Unless I have zoomed out and I can't tell. No, I haven't. Well, you can see him. Oh god, I've lost the park. Okay, okay. And then where the hell is the park? Alright, see ya, see ya. Alright, there we go. There's our Entelodon. Very cool. Very, very cool indeed. Our first ever glacial creature. That's it for this today's recording. Stick around for about 2 seconds time. I don't know why I keep saying this. You guys don't know it's past time. You guys don't know I'm recording this in a day's time. I'm going to stop telling you. I'm going to go. Yeah. Yeah. He's awesome, isn't he? Look at him. He's cute. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. 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 Okie dokie. As I kind of suspected, I don't really have much left to do in the rest of this video. It is the next day. Let's check our social messages quickly. Connor Armstrong, I thank you. Lovely. Now, if we nip up top, I have started to expand the park. Oh, there we go. Boop, boop. I have started to expand the park, so I've knocked out 3 of these since the last video. That one's on the way. These are about, you know, that's a good 250,000 worth of gold there, plus knocking these out. But that should get us a new dinosaur or 2 with a little bit of luck, and hopefully we can have that for the next episode, at least one of them ready. I have been very unfortunate with my aquatic and my glacial dinosaurs and my glacial creatures, and I simply don't have any ready at this point in time. There's nothing coming through. The world has decided to hate me. So let me just sniff around, collect some coins. Now, as you can see, I've gone a little bit mad on the security things, but I figure if I get, why do I keep saying figure? Figure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There's like 15 or so there. So that's 45 times 420 an hour is what, 4,200, 16,800. That's for, I can't bother working that out. It's about 20,000, if not a little bit less, per hour, just from these buildings. That's why I've done it, that's why I've stocked up. I mean, it will be when I've got the next sort of seven or so that I need there. I think I just needed, I keep saying figure. I just need a decent income. I've noticed that my gold was starting to maybe fall behind a little bit. It wasn't going that well. You know, I was struggling to afford things. I was struggling to afford meat and crops, which I've gone ahead and I've got them going on at the moment because, well, I kind of need them. So I'd like to get the Brachiosaurus leveled up, and but we are going to work on the Pachycephalosaurus, get that up to level 40, and oh, stop bumping into each other, and our Dilophosaurus, who's over here. Lovely. Anyways, there's really not much else to show you guys in this episode in terms of my own dinosaurs, my own creatures. So, as per usual, and I did forget to do this last time, I do apologise, we're going to nip and we're going to visit somebody else. And level 48, Jesus Christ, Alex, that is crazy. That is absolutely crazy. We're going to visit, I'm trying to think of people who've commented. Someone preferably a little higher, we're looking for sort of a 17, 18... 24 is a bit high, I'm afraid. Devon! We're going to visit Devon. I'm very worried that I will end up visiting people repeatedly, and there's actually quite a good chance of that happening, but... Devon, I apologise if I visited you before. Okie dokie, here we go. This is Devon's... No, we've not been here. Oh, you've evolved your pterodactylus already. Huh. Now, he's clearly gone for this idea that... your carnivores should be all stuck together, because that helps in terms of the finger midgy code red mechanism. It's kind of an odd park. No offence, Devon. I'm trying to say that in a not insulting way. It's not a bad park, it's just an odd park. I don't know really what to say about it. We're gonna move on. We're gonna go find another park. I like your park, Devon. Thumbs up for Devon. Was that awkward? I think that was awkward. I don't know. Everybody likes different things. Let's put it that way. Let's go check one more out before the end of the episode. Oh, have a gift, Adam. Okay, I saw someone in level 16. Arjun. We shall visit Arjun. Arjun? 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 I mean, it's Arjun, isn't it? Tell me your name. Let's have a looky loo, see what we've got. Okay, oh Jesus Christ, you like your purple. Bloody Nora. That's a lot of purple side things. Your Triceratops must make an absolute fortune. Huh, it's actually not an awful idea. Nice grown up Spinosaurus there. Bloody hell. very nice indeed. You've gone heavy on the plants, I see. Which is fair enough, it does make sense long term, it's just not something I can be bothered with personally. It's definitely a good idea. And tell you what, while we're here, let's go ahead and check out an aquatic park as well. I will do glacial parks, but I'll do them when I'm a bit higher level. I'd love to visit the level 48 park, I really would. But I don't want to do that until I don't want to visit anyone higher level, just because I don't want to spoil it for you guys. Maybe you haven't seen all the dinosaurs yet, some of you. I wouldn't want to show you something that's above my own level. I don't want to spoil it for myself as well. I quite like seeing everything for the first time. Let me just collect some gold. Boop, 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 boop. I are trying to level up Zifactinus. It's actually very close. Not quite close enough. One more and it'll get a bit bigger. So let's... I might just upgrade this. Can I afford that? Nah, screw it. Let's do it. It's only cheap. It's only cheap. And we have a social message. Thank you, Jacob Davis. And let's go visit somebody. Now, they're going to have to be a decent level because I am in the aquatic park. Oh, yeah, we visited your land park. Let's visit your aquatic park as well. See what you've done under the water. Under the sea. Everything is better when you get wetter. Take it from me. I mean, it's crashed. It's crashed. I don't understand. It does this occasionally. People keep asking, what do I use to play this on the PC? I've told people about a bazillion times, but I will tell it again. This is a program called BlueStacks. You can go download it for free right now. It's in beta. It will, I believe, cost money when it's out of beta, but for now it is for free. So go check it out. It's BlueStacks, and you just download it. You have to. It's kind of a pain in the ass. You have to sync it with a phone and do all this malarkey, but you guys will be able to figure it out, I'm sure. Thank you very much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. Please do like and subscribe for more Jurassic Park Builder, Turok, horror games, and more dinosaur games down the line as soon as one of them ends. Yeah, that's about it, really. Cheers. Thanks for watching. Much love. Bye-bye.